know that you were wondering why you're here right now. I wish that I could tell you what's been bothering my mind. I've got a family that I really love.
Adamu
gives me everything.
Adamu
and so much more.
Adamu,
until you came along. And I fell in love with you.
Adamu,
I didn't know
what happened to your face.
Don't bother, it's a long story.
Wait, there's something I have to tell you, okay? I don't have much time to spend here, okay? Look, I want to tell you something. You see, my husband and I, we've been having this problem. We're having this problem, you know, and after I met you.
What are you talking about?
What's going on?
Are you expecting anyone?
No.
What's
going on? And who's trying to break my case? The right to leave your house to other people's houses, bang at my gates as if you built this house for me, and you're here asking me of your wife without the courtesy of an introduction? Does this place look like a police station or
who do you think you're talking to? Or you don't know I'm Susan's husband? Now tell me where she is before I lose my temper. I'm going to count to two. And if you don't tell me where she is...
Look, what do you want? Ah! 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 Ah!
Ah!
Ah! Ah!
One?
I'm sorry. Please, let's just go.
Will you shut up? You're not even ashamed of yourself. Look at both of you. Take a look. Take a look at that. I said, take a look at that. See the show of shame you have made of yourself. Now where do I begin to shoot from?
Sir, please, I
you know what the Bible says about coveting other people's wives?
Please, I could explain, please. Please, I could explain. Please.
Please, I beg you in the name of God. Please don't do this. Let's just go home and stop this.
Please shut your mouth. What did I not do for you? Eh? What was my shortcoming? I have loved you from the very first day to this very moment. So tell me, where did I go wrong? By giving you all my heart? I wasn't comfortable when you started this business venture of yours, but I had to give in because I wanted you to be happy. And this is how you pay me back for trusting you? No problem.
Sir, please.
Will you shut up?
Sir, please, I'm very sorry, sir. She was married. Please, sir. Please forgive me. Please.
Forgive you? Forgive you for breaking my marriage? My home? The very essence of my existence? Men like you are not worthy to live. Men like you are not worthy to live.
It was a flesh wound.
The bullet passed right through. So no vital organs were affected. But I assure you, she'll come around very soon. No problem about that.
That's okay, doctor. For now, I want you to give her all the medical attention she needs. But something still bothers me. I don't seem to believe the statement the husband made to the police. That's why I want you to move her to a private ward until she regains consciousness.
Yeah, that's not a problem, but what do I tell your husband when he comes around?
Well, tell him you're acting under police instructions.
All right.
That reminds me, you said you saw a gun behind him when he came here.
Yeah, I actually did, but he quickly covered it when he knew I saw it. That was why I demanded for police report.
That was very smart of you, doctor.
Thank you.
Anyway, I have to be going now. I'll see you tomorrow. Meanwhile, if there are any new developments, please call me.
Okay. And one more thing, Inspector. He actually said and insisted that he should be the first to know when a wife regains consciousness.
He really said that?
Oh, sure.
I want you to disregard that. Do as I said.
All right.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, section. No problems.
All right.
Good.
Thank you.
it feels so right. I gotta let it. The love and attention that you gave to me, I keep on remembering. I cannot let it go. All I know inside of me, this has got to stop. I've got to go back home where I do belong. Oh baby, this is wrong, but it feels so right. I've got to let this go. Yes. That was the day we supervised the student doctors who came in from the general hospital for the final IT program.
You see. At what time did he leave the hospital?
Between 7 and 7.30 p.m. Just before I handed over to the night shift staff. Is everything okay, sir?
Not to worry, nurse. Everything is under control for now. I would like you to call me if you see him first.
Okay.
Right. Here's my card.
Okay.
Please call me.
I'll do that.
Have yourself a nice day.
You too. Bye.
Excuse me, officer.
Yes.
Have I heard you asking questions about Dr. Mark?
Yes. Did you perchance see him?
Yes, I did, but that was before and after he was attacked.
Attacked? By who?
I didn't know who he was, but I heard the other man that came with him. Call him Peter. No. Peterson.
Peterson. All right. Thank you. Thank you very much. State Criminal Investigation Department. I want to see Mr. Philip.
Please, sir, I hope there's no problem, sir. I hope he's not in trouble, sir.
No, my sister, there's no problem at all. I just want to ask him something, that's all.
Okay, sir. He went to Abuja for a police training exam, and I really don't know when he'll come back.
Well, I see. So he wants to be an officer, too. Anyway, thanks a lot. Please tell him when he comes back that I came to look for him.
And he should come to Central Police Station as soon as he returns. And that's for Inspector Thompson. Okay?
Okay, sir.
For the mother of Dr. Mark and attempted murder of your wife.
right to remain silent. Anything you say may be used against you in a court of law.
What's
you have the right to call your lawyer when we get to the station.
What's the meaning of this?
You should tell us where his wife is and not this. We're just coming from the ward and she's not there.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, sir. I'll not tell you anything until we get to the station. Gina Peterson,
you have a right to make only 2 phone calls, but when we get to the station.
Hey, wait.
Hold on, that's it. Tony, please, pick up my daughter from school. Take care of her, then yourself and Thelma work on the stadium project. I'll call my lawyer and my father at once. Let's go.
Justice J.K. Akinwumi presiding.
Do we know the business of the day?
Yes, my lord.
We have case number 173.
A case of murder.
An attempted murder. Held before this court this day. Between Angela Peterson, Ogoshuku, Ojuku versus the states.
Will the two counsel move to the bench, please?
I need to be sure that I will not teach you your job in this court. I will not entertain any statement that has nothing to do with this case.
Yes.
You may go.
The court calls to stand Angela Peterson, Ogoshuku Ojuku.
Are you a Christian, Muslim, or a beggar?
I'm a Christian.
Then do swear. I swear by Almighty God.
I swear by Almighty God.
That the evidence I shall give in this case.
That the evidence I shall give in this case.
Before this court.
Before this court.
Shall be the truth.
Shall be the truth.
The whole truth.
The whole truth.
And nothing but the truth.
And nothing but the truth.
So help me God.
So help me God.
My Lord.
The witness is under oath. And is standing trial for the murder of Dr. Mark Dixon, whose body is yet to be discovered by the police, and also attempted murder of his wife, Mrs. Susan Ojuku.
Are you guilty or not, Mr. Ojuku?
Not guilty, my lord.
The state counsel may begin a cross-examination of the accused now.
Mr. Peterson Ojuku, could you kindly tell this honorable court your name, your age, your occupation and address?
My name is Peterson Ugochukwu Ojukwu. I'm a building and site development engineer. I'm 40 years old.
Are you married or do you have a woman in your life?
Yes, I am married. My wife's name is Susan Ayoade Ojukwu. I also have a daughter.
Mr. Peterson Ojukwu, do you remember the 17th of July 2004? Do you remember being caught by your wife on that day in a rather compromising position with your secretary?
Objection, my lord. The private affair of my client is not relevant to this case.
Overruled.
The witness will answer this question.
My lord, on the day in question, an ant stung me in the back. And when I shouted, my secretary ran into my office and helped me remove it.
Are you aware that your wife is into corporate gifts and adverts management?
Yes, I gave her the money to start the business.
Is it true that your wife runs her business together with taking care of your daughter, which sometimes makes her come home tired?
That is the main reason I never wanted her to work in the first place. I made good provisions for her, but she insisted on going out to work.
Can you recollect the 30th of September 2004 when you raped your wife and beat her into coma?
That is a lie.
Mr. Peterson, please answer yes or no.
Objection, my lord.
Yes?
The question is leading.
Sustain. State Counsel, rephrase your question.
Yes, Your Honor. I put it to you, Mr. Peterson Ojukwu, that on the 3rd of October that you went to Dr. Mark's house and shot him and your wife Susan.
I did not kill him.
My lord. Let it be on record of this honorable court that Mr. Peterson Ojukwu went to Dr. Mark's house, who happens to be his wife's business partner and an artist, and shot him and his wife Susan. He took Dr. Mark's body and buried it in an undisclosed grave. But luckily, his wife survived the gunshot.
That is a big lie.
My lord, that will be all for now. I'll call back the accused later.
Mr. Duku,
you may step down now.
Do you promise to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you, God?
Yes, I do.
My lord, the witness is on that oath.
Please, madam, could you tell this court your name and your relationship with the accused person?
My name's Mrs. Thelma Chigozie Egeku. I was his personal secretary and presently his general manager, and the wife to his best friend and business partner, Mr. Anthony Eliwichi.
And how long have you known Mr. Peterson?
I have worked with him for over 11 years now. But I got to know him in the real sense of knowing a man 3 years ago.
What do you mean in the real sense of knowing a man?
You would not understand. You see, I came to Lagos without even having a school leaving certificate. But when I...
Objection, my lord. I don't see the relevance of her telling us her life history.
My lord, this woman is the only staff of my client who started his business with him long before he got married. So, whatever she tells us could help us analyze the true psychology of Mr. Peterson.
Overruled. Madam, go ahead.
But when I saw him at the business center where I had gone to make photocopies for my uncle, he called me and asked me if I would like to work. That was the beginning of my life.
So, what happened from then on? Did he start dating or sleeping with you?
I wish then that he had. But no. Instead, he paid for a room for me when I had problems with my uncle's wife. Made me sit for GCE and UMU. Increased my salary and paid for my school fees until I finished my BSc program in UNILAG. Today, I'm glad to say that I'm his general manager. He's my father, my brother. He calls me his little sister. He called me a few days ago to come pick up his daughter. But he never told me that his wife was having an affair outside their marriage.
Are you telling this court that Mr. Peterson never at any time tried to date or force you to sleep with him?
Never. He is the only family I have in Lagos.
tell this court? How many girlfriends did he have before getting married to Susan?
Just one. Her name was Abioye Akinwumi. She stays in London now with her husband. He actually wanted to marry her, but her father refused.
One last thing, Mrs. Akinwumi. How would you describe your boss?
If he had asked me to date or marry him, I would have accepted it all my life. But that is not to discredit my husband. My boss is a perfect gentleman with a great sense of responsibility and understanding.
That would be all for now, my lord.
Does the state counsel wish to cross-examine this witness? Mrs. Thelma, you may step down for now.
The state wishes to call Inspector Thompson Williams.
May Inspector Thompson Williams please proceed to the witness box.
Inspector Thompson, how did you discover there was no armed robbery shootout in the area that day?
After Mr. Peterson told me what happened to his wife, I visited the area with my men on investigation and asked the people around if any such incident happened. No one claimed to have heard or seen anything. Then the doctor called me after Mrs. Ojukwu recovered consciousness. And it was from her that we learned that it was actually Mr. Peterson that shot his wife and Dr. Mark.
Did she tell you how she was shot and what became of Dr. Mark?
Not really, but she said when he was about to shoot Dr. Mark, she jumped in front of the gun and slumped.
I believe he must have gone ahead to shoot Dr. Mark and carried him somewhere to dump him or even buried him.
Objection, my lord! This witness has no right to conclude for this court whether my client murdered and buried Dr. Mark until proven beyond every reasonable doubt that that incident actually took place.
Sustained. Inspector Tom, you will not teach this court how to conclude this case.
I understand, my lord.
Inspector Tom, in your statement, and you said you found an automatic revolver with the accused. Could you explain further?
Yes, the doctor told me that he saw a gun behind him on that very day, at his back.
So when we got to the location, I actually saw a bullet impact on the floor beside the gate, exactly the way the wife had described. And when we got to the house, I found the gun.
You did?
Yes.
My lord, that would be all for now.
Does the defense counsel wish to examine him?
Yes, my lordship. My lord, I tender this as an exhibit.
Mark this exhibit 1.
Inspector Thompson, do you in any way recognize this report?
Yes, but this has nothing to do with this case.
My lord, the document you have before you is a medical report of a young girl who was impregnated by the son of an influential politician. And our dearest Inspector Thompson was in charge of the case. And he worked with Dr. Mark, who was the chief surgeon in the hospital where the little girl was admitted.
Objection, my lord.
Overrule. Continue, defense counsel.
Thank you, my lord. The young girl lost her womb in the process. And our Inspector Thompson and Dr. Mark went behind the DPO of the station and collected a whooping sum of 3 million naira from the politician. And shared it with Dr. Mark. So, Inspector Thompson, I put it to you that you know where Dr. Mark is, yet you have refused to bring him to this court to testify for fornicating with Mrs. Suzanne Ojukwu, and that you have planned for marriage behind her legitimate husband, whom you are framing up to conveniently get him out of the way to enable Dr. Mark to marry her in France.
You're a liar.
I did not take any money from anybody, okay? I did my job and I did it diligently.
Inspector Chow.
Yes, my lord.
Mind your reaction. I will not allow such language in my court.
I apologize, my lord.
My lord, I have a witness who will testify that on the night of the incident, Dr. Mark was seen in the hospital with somebody whose description fits Inspector Thompson. Finally, I want it to be recorded in this court that our dear Inspector Thompson obtained statement from Mrs. Suzanne Ojukwu without allowing her husband access to her. And I want to ask our dear Inspector, why?
My lord, we were only trying to save the life of that young woman when we suspected that
he may try to kill her if he finds out that she spoke to the police. That was all.
My lord, let me ask our diligent inspector this question. How can a man who rushes his own wife to the hospital while she is unconscious in a bid to save her life now turn around and murder her when she regains consciousness? My dear inspector, I ask you, why? That will be all for now, my lord.
You may step down for now, Inspector Tom. The court's now adjourned till Monday next week. Arrives.
Court!
Sir, he never thought that it would be like this.
All he told me was that he was going to deal with the boy, not to kill him.
Okay, how do we find the boy's body?
So that's a problem we have to solve before Monday.
What of those keys you told me he gave you? Have you checked what he kept in his drawers? Because I believe that police boy has some interest in this case.
I have given the lawyer the pictures and other relevant documents. He's studying them as we speak. But wait. Philip, where can we find Philip?
Who is Philip?
Philip was the boy Peter hired, so to speak, to monitor the wife's movement. He took some incriminating pictures of the wife and Dr. McDavis. Those were the pictures I gave to the lawyer with other relevant documents. So Philip is the only one who has had them speak together.
Yes, and maybe if you get him to testify in court, it may make things easier for Mr. Peterson. What do you think?
Why don't you go for the boy while I go back to the prison?
Mrs. Suzanne Ojukwu, can you tell this court your true relationship with Dr. Mark?
We don't have any relationship. Dr. Mark asked me to marry him, but I made a very big mistake, you know, but I'm sorry.
Madam, did you at any time discuss business with Dr. Mark, who also doubles as your artist?
Yes. Yes.
paints for me and also helps in developing my design plans.
Did you ever have lunch or dinner dates with him?
Yes, on several occasions. I'd also been to his house where he used as a studio. On the day you wear shorts,
can you tell the scout what happened?
I don't want to lose my husband. I don't want to lose my husband.
Please. Madam, please. The life of Dr. Mark, your partner and artist, is at stake here. And it's only you who witness whether he was killed or not. So please tell the Scott what happened.
On that day, I went to Dr. Mark's house. Then my husband found out. So he came there to look for me. And I hid in the security post. The one he threatened to kill Dr. Mark if he failed to produce me, I came out. I jumped in front of the gunman and he tried to shoot Dr. Mark in order to stop him, but it was already too late. My husband shot me. That is all I can remember. I don't know if he killed Dr. Mark or not.
That would be all for me.
The defense counsel may proceed with his cross-examination.
Thank you, my lord. I tender these photographs as exhibit.
As exhibit 2.
As your lordship pleases.
Madam, I'm sorry for the bullet wound. Now, have you seen those photographs before?
Yes. Philip told me about it and my husband brought it to Dr. Mark's house on that day.
And you still want to retain in your statement that you never had any formal relationship with Dr. Mark?
No, I did it because I was upset over what I saw in
my... No, madam. Your relationship with Dr. Mark started when you had the bike accident. Not when you saw your husband and his secretary Fina in the office. True or false?
It's not...
Please, answer the question, Mrs. Ojukwu. Did you start seeing Dr. Mark before or after the incident in your husband's office?
It was before the incident.
Your husband, after 2 weeks, tried to make peace with you over the incident in his office. But you still went on seeing Dr. Mark and denied your own husband his joy of matrimonial purpose and right. Because in those pictures, you were seen with Dr. Mark on different occasions. In the hotels, restaurant, and even in his own home.
Objection, my lord.
Overruled. breast cancer continued.
On the night you claim to have been raped by your husband, you had sex with Dr. Mark earlier on in the day, right?
That's not true. That's not a lie.
I'm sorry, Peter. I'm sorry, Peter.
Look, I will take it as a yes. Now, are you saying that you never told him when you first met that you were married?
I tried to, but he didn't listen.
Mrs. Suzanne Ojukwu, take a look at your husband. That man there is standing trial today for murder because of your unfaithfulness and your filthy lifestyle. He married you, educated you till you obtained your BSc and master's degree. Yet you want to send him to jail? Tell this court how you were paid to send your own daughter's father to jail and how you plan to travel to France with Dr. Mark.
Objection, my lord.
Sustained.
I never meant any evil. It's all my fault. It's just a mistake. This is my husband. I don't want to send him to jail. Please.
My lord, I have a man who investigated the activities of Mrs. Susan Ojukwu and Dr. Mark, and he is prepared to testify to that effect in this court. Finally, my lord, I want it to be on record that Mrs. Susan Ojukwu, Dr. Mark, Davis Dixon, and Inspector Thompson Williams are up to some crimes, and they should be made to face the full wrath of the law. That will be all, my lord.
You may step down, madam. This court is adjourned to 5D for final hearing. Arise!
Get you a glass of water.
Yeah, and a very cold one at that.
Okay.
Good day to you, madam.
Who are you? And how did you get in here?
Excuse us, I'd like to sort things out with Inspector Tom here.
Police? What are you doing with a police officer? Excuse me, officer. Is my son in any kind of trouble?
There's no problem. Tom here is my friend.
There's a problem. I'm sorry, madam. I have to arrest your son.
If he does not tell me the things I want to know right now. What are you talking about, Tom? What has come over you?
You will be acting stupid, Mark.
I want to know what happened in your house here. What is going on between you and Peter Snackler's wife?
What are you people talking about? Eh? Mark, do you have problems with anybody in the office?
I'm not at all, Mom. Mom, please excuse us, okay? I'll explain things later.
And I say no. I want you to explain in her presence. This case has gone to court, and everybody believes that you were killed and buried by Mr. Peterson Akala.
Killed? Oh my God. Mark, what nonsense have you gotten yourself into? What?
Mom, it's a long story, okay?
Oh my God.
That's all I have to say.
She never told me she was married.
I managed to treat myself that night and ran out of town that same night.
So, Mrs. Akala never told you she was married?
No.
All right. Why didn't you tell her husband the story then?
He didn't even give me a chance to explain myself. Besides, he had pictures of us in his possession.
This girl you're talking about,
is she the same girl you wanted me to meet?
Yes, Mom. But she never told me she was married. She only told me she had a child.
Mark. I want you to come to court the day after tomorrow.
I don't want that basket mouth of a lawyer to call me to the witness box again.
Besides, he's already casting aspersions on my integrity as an officer of the law.
My son, you have to make yourself available for them to see that you're not dead. I'll go with you, okay?
I know a retired judge who could help us if the case turns bad. Okay?
I wish I never met her. I wish I never met her in the first place.
It's okay.
I'll do as you've said, Mom.
Tom, what can I get you?
Well, I think I'll just take my leave now.
Thank you very much, officer.
All right, Mom.
But why didn't you come home after you were discharged? Huh?
Listen to me, my daughter. You have made your mistakes. And I thank God you're alive. But you need to be strong for your daughter and pray for your husband.
Susie, if there is anyone who stands a better chance of helping Peterson win this case, that person is you. We make mistakes. Just like I blamed myself for advising him to send a secret investigator after you. I can go on and on and on. Tell you how I planted that evil seed of hatred in him. But it would make no positive impact. We must all work together with his lawyer to win this case.
Susie, you have to be strong for him. He needs you now more than ever.
I will be in that court on Friday.
Honey, we have to leave now. It's getting late. You know, Jessica is all alone at home.
All right. Susie.
I'll come with the lawyer tomorrow.
But please, you mustn't speak to anyone about this issue, okay? I'll see you tomorrow.
I wanted to kill him, my lord. I just wanted to scare him so that he could leave my wife alone. I guess I took my anger too far. I shot at him, but she blocked him and took the bullet for him. And I got very angry when he went to help her and I shot at him again. I didn't wait to see if he was dead or not. All I was concerned about was taking my wife to the
we got to the hospital, the doctor insisted on seeing a police report. Now we had to go back to the police. I didn't know what to tell the police people, so I just told them that she had been shot by armed robbers. So I could get the police report from them. I went back to the hospital. All I was concerned about was the safety and well-being of my wife, because I love my wife very much.
Did you at any time during your crisis with your wife plead with her for forgiveness and understanding?
Yes, I did, but she wouldn't have me back. I would never ever rape my wife. Never.
That would be all, my lord.
The state counsel may cross-examine the accused.
Engineer Peterson Ojukwu, can you tell these courts in one simple language why you should not be regarded as a murderer?
Look, if I had wanted to kill my wife or the doctor, I would have done it very conveniently without any finger pointing at me. No one saw me enter that compound and no one saw me leave.
So, where then did you bury Dr. Mark? Where did you bury Dr. Mark?
I didn't...
I'm still very much alive.
Jesus.
I'm not dead. Please, sir, forgive me. I never knew she was your wife.
Does somebody control this madness in my court? Who is this man?
My lord, may I ask this court to recognize the presence of Dr. Mark Davis Dixon? The very person being claimed to have been murdered by my client.
I request to see both counsels and their client right now in my chambers.
You need to know the meaning of the madness that occurred in my courtroom.
My lord, I sincerely apologize, but this man is the same doctor whom my learned colleague and the inspector claimed was murdered by my client. My lord, I pray that you allow him to testify in this case.
My lord, I'm sorry for the unannounced intrusion. I never had any form of notification of his coming.
I pray your understanding, my lord.
I warned both of you from the beginning of the proceeding that I will not tolerate any form of dramatic display in my courtroom. And for your information, I know this young man more than any of you. He would have been my son-in-law, but for reasons best known to me, it never worked. Come in. Who is that?
Oh,
how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
It's been a long time.
Yes.
How is my friend Dixon?
He's doing great.
Okay.
How's your family, sir?
Oh, God, it's massive. What are you doing here? Are you involved in this case? I saw you in the courtroom.
Somehow. The doctor here is my son.
Oh. Too bad.
Your Honor. My name is Dr. Peters. Engineer Peterson is my son.
Oh, you are welcome.
Excuse me, sorry. Have we met?
I don't think I know you, sir.
Are you perchance related to Chief Badmus Adedeji, the former commissioner of police?
Yes, that's my father. Do you know him?
Then you must be his second daughter, Biola. Am I right?
That's my name. I can't seem to place your face, sir.
Can you recall an incident that happened some years back?
When my son gave you an injury on your left eye.
Yes. You remembered my face.
Yes, I am good at remembering faces.
You actually know her.
Yes. Yes, you know.
We lived in the same neighborhood for many years in the 80s. Yeah, but I remember a particular incident when my son gave her an injury on her left eye.
How's your son, sir?
That's why we are here, my dear. Your Honor, the two people involved in this case are actually brothers.
They are blood brothers that were separated some years back.
They also have a third brother, Your Honor. He was adopted by Justice Uwakwe Egepu, who died 2 years ago. Before he died, he wrote me a letter. He gave me the phone number and address of Tony. That's one of the reasons why I came back to Nigeria, to be able to locate him.
Tony. Tony Egeku. Tony Egeku. I've known him for about a year now, and we do business together. He's in the courtroom. Could it be the same person?
It's possible.
Come in.
Good day, my lord.
You're welcome.
Good day, everybody.
Good day.
Peterson, what's going on?
I don't know, Tony. This lady just made a certain revelation. I'd like you to hear it straight from her.
I was actually trying to explain to them that both of them are related. They are blood brothers.
That's impossible.
That's not all. They have a third brother, second in the line, by name Tony. He was adopted by Justice Uwakwe Egeku, who died 2 years ago.
My name is Anthony Egeku. Justice Egeku was my father.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
This is wonderful. Then the three of you are related. You're blood brothers from the same parents.
That's impossible. That's just scandalous.
Listen, Tony. I adopted Mark. Justice Uwakwe Egeku adopted you. Yes, and Dr. Peters adopted Peterson. So you're all from the same parents.
I have sent for the police DPO.
But he told me he won't be able to make it down here.
I am suggesting that
we take those kids back to their relatives.
Doctor, I'm not sure you would understand the outcome of that action. You see, Doctor, I employed your father. He worked for me for 10 good years before he died.
He had no relative.
Even his wife is either from Ghana or Cameroon. I'm not too sure of the place. So where do we take them to?
Doctor,
why don't you adopt these children?
I mean, I don't have a child of my own. And my husband is due to go back to France very soon. Why don't you process the adoption papers?
I would like to have a new baby.
Doctor, don't you think that is about the best thing to be done? You see, Doctor,
my wife and I lost our son 2 years ago. And at the moment, she cannot have a child due to some medical complications. Mm.
And adopting a son for her is not a bad idea at all. Moreover, she likes Akala's second son, Tony.
I guess that leaves me with the first son, isn't it?
Okay, let us go ahead and make the arrangement and later we invite the police to witness.
Don't worry about that, Doctor.
I will get all the legal documents ready by Monday. You just go ahead to provide the police report.
So, in that case, I keep the keys with me. I mean, when the papers are ready, pick them up from my place.
Yes. That's a very good idea. I will send my driver to drop you at home.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much,
Doctor.
Let me.
You mean to tell me that we all are... that we all are related?
Blood brothers.
Counselors, approach the bench, please.
State Counsel, what is your stand in this case?
My lord, based on the last physical evidence in this court, the state would like to withdraw all prosecuting process against Engineer Peterson Ojukwu.
The first counsel? My lord, we are delighted to applaud my learned colleague for her courage and understanding. And above all, we are very grateful to this honorable court.
You may have your seats.
Is hereby dismissed from further hearing in the court of law.
Arise.
Differences, and we've made mistakes. But if you hadn't taken the bullet for my brother, he probably might have been dead by now. So let's put the past behind us and start afresh. I forgive you.
Can I ever face you three again? Can I ever face your brothers again? Can't.
Okay.
d'amour ici. On sait déjà, c'est rigolo là.
L'amour ici, l'amour ici.